We shall now discuss about monopoly. We know the term market is derived from the word mercatus. And so, monopoly originated from the Greek word monos and polyen, which means alone to sell. So, monopoly is originated from the Greek words monos and polyen, which means alone to sell. So, as the term specifies, there is only one single seller or one seller of a particular commodity, and a market condition in which there is a single seller, if there is only one seller, we can call him a monopolist. So his product will not have any close substitutes, there will be no competition for him, so it is easy for him to control the market. So the monopoly, as per definition, is defined as a market situation in which a single seller or producer sells a product or service which has no close substitutes. So when there is a single seller selling a product or service which is having no close substitutes, it is known as monopoly. For example, Kerala State Electricity Board, because it controls the transmission, distribution and generation of electricity. So monopoly is a market structure in which there is a single seller. There is no close substitute for the commodity, and there are barriers to entry because it do not want to have, or it do not wish to promote competition. So mono and poly both used together in order to coin the word monopoly. Monopoly arises from various sources. Therefore, they are generally classified into natural, legal, voluntary and social monopoly. There are further other categories of monopoly, but the major four are natural, legal, social and voluntary monopoly. So natural monopolies arises out of natural scarcity. Legal monopolies as part of the rules and regulations. There are something else known as social monopoly. Sometimes monopolies are created out of social interest and social necessity. For example, you telegraph, railways, electricity, post, waters, etc. There are voluntary monopolies such as trust, in which two or more firms producing the same commodity may voluntarily enter into the process of activities or production, whatever they want, and then they form different kinds of monopoly. There are other aspects such as social monopoly, legal monopoly, fiscal monopoly, simple monopoly, and also discriminating monopoly and chosen monopoly. So there are different varieties of monopoly. Now coming to the features of monopoly, there is one firm to produce. The sole proprietor, if it is a partnership, then the partnership has the total control. There is free entry and exit in the case of perfect competition. In the case of monopoly, there is no such permissions. The entry is quite prohibited so that he can control the entire market. So absolute control of the production and supply of the commodity is done by the monopolist himself. So he doesn't have much control. The product of the monopolist will not have much of a substitute. That is why he acts as a competitor or as a monopolist. He can choose discriminative prices. Discrimination on the basis of degree and types is one of the most important features of monopoly. He is a price maker than a price taker. The major comparison between perfect competition and monopoly is he is a price maker.